Welcome everybody, I'm Alexander Linz, Head of Content of WatchAdvisor.com, the largest search engine for wristwatches and official retailers on the net. Let me give you a short summary of day one here in Basel. As you all know, yesterday, Wednesday, the show was not open. It was open only for the press, so we had the advantage to get in and see the first things. Today, the show is open. The doors have been opening almost a couple of minutes ago, so the crowd is coming in now. And a short summary of what we have seen yesterday. First thing we did, we saw the novelties of Nomos Glashütte, a small and cool manufacturer located in Glashütte in Germany, Saxony. They have presented a variety of nice, interesting models. There's one watch I particularly very much like with them because I did not expect it at all to see such a watch with Nomos, because you all know they're pretty conservative when it comes to designs. They stay absolutely in line. They don't make any exercises to get left or right or to use, let's say, fancy colors or applications on the dials. And they did one. It's called Autobahn, like the German highway, Autobahn. And this watch is really amazing. I love it. It's fantastic. Have a look at it. We will have pictures online. And there are already some pictures online on our YouTube channel, on our website, watchadvisor.com. So Nomos really did a nice job with a German designer. This watch, Autobahn, will make its way, and I think it's a new step for Nomos. We saw Rolex. I already discussed Rolex in an own video, so if you want to know what happened with Rolex, please have a look at that video. We also saw novelties of Chopard yesterday. Chopard, they presented an absolutely incredible all-in-one watch. So this watch includes bipedal calendar, sunrise, sunset, the equation of time. There is an absolutely precision moon phase on the backside. So this is kind of an all-in-one watch, 500 or more components, an amazing watch. It's, I just have to say, you have to say in French, chapeau or congratulations or whatever. Chopard is doing an amazing job these years and last years with its manufacturer, LUC, and we also saw the Strike One, a minute repeater of Chopard that has a crystal gong. So there are no typical gongs as you have them in a regular minute repeater, but a crystal gong. They use the entire glass of the watch to maximize and to make the watch sound better and louder. So this is also an amazing timepiece. And 30 years of Mille Miglia with Chopard. This is also something that has to be celebrated. Of course, Chopard is presenting a variety of Mille Miglia chronographs in the typical colors of the race cars. So you will find the colors of the race cars of France, Italy, of course, Belgium, and Germany. So you will see these watches are also really good looking. Yeah, then we saw Kalev Bucherer. They are also having an anniversary, 130 years. They were been founded in 1888. And Kalev Bucherer presented its very own first developed manufactured tourbillon. That's amazing for a brand that has been established only a couple years ago, and it's Bucherer, the big retailer that recently also bought Tourneaux in the States, so it's the biggest retailer on earth now. They have their own brand called KLF Bucherer, and I did an interview with Sascha Möri, and he presented me very proud. He was proud, of course, he had to be proud. His first tourbillon, that's really a cool watch. Have a look at it on our website. And last but not least, we saw new world records, not only one, but several new world records. Jean-Christophe Babin from Bulgaria presented us the first thinnest automatic watch, including a tourbillon that is so thin, you almost think the watch is not there. And I was joking around with Jean-Christophe yesterday, saying, okay, Jean-Christophe, if you continue doing these watches even thinner and thinner all the time, some moment there will be no more watch on your wrist, and the watches might get so thin as a banknote. So we were joking around, but these watches are amazing. The knowledge and technology behind to do so ultra-thin watches is simply stunning. And if you go and look at that ultra-thin tourbillon, it is made out of 350 components. So have a look at this watch on our website. Have a look at the video, the taped video with the interview with Jean-Christophe Babin, and imagine so thin, 350 components. That's just incredible. And what they also did, last year they presented a minute repeater, and they now included or put this minute repeater into a carbon case. And carbon seems to be the ideal material to make a minute repeater, because this tiny little, also ultra thin watch, sounds like a ghetto blaster. It's amazing. Big sound, great sound, wonderful watch. So this was day one, a little summary of what we saw. We are heading now to the next adventures here in Basel. It's the first day for the public. The crowd is coming in. Stay tuned, look at our videos. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and to like, of course, our videos.